Could the Eagle Scouts please come up? I would like to welcome everyone and thank you for coming to the Troop 250 Eagle Court of Honor. At this time, I would like to introduce Alex Surrett, York District Executive, to convene this Eagle Court of Honor.
Good afternoon, everyone. By the authority vested in me as a representative of the Palmetto Council and the National Council of the Boy Scouts of America, I declare this Eagle Court of Honor in session. Today we have the honor and pleasure of recognizing three candidates for the award of Eagle. Honor Guard, please. Well, these are the Eagle candidates. So number one, let's be on.
Would everyone please stand for the presentation of our colors and the Pledge of Allegiance? Color Guard, present the colors. Scout Salute, would everyone please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Two. Color Guard, press the colors. You may be seated. It is my pleasure to introduce Pastor Johnny Carrozo, who will lead us in our invocation.
Let's pray. Father, we're just so grateful that we're able to meet freely in a place to honor these three young men. For families and friends, Father, they've watched them grow up from little boys to adolescents, and now to become actually full-grown men. We thank you for their lives. We pray for them as they move forward. Father, pray that they would give you honor. In Jesus' name, amen.
I would like to introduce Robert Mercer, York District Advancement Chairman, to present the Trail to Eagle.
Scouts, look back for a moment. Look back over the cliff you have climbed. Look back at the experience you have encountered in your ascent. His experiences should not be forgotten. And you should profit by making sure that the adverse ones do not occur again. Experience is a valuable teacher if you heed his teachings. Remember your first trip along the steep trail. At first, your brothers called you scout. Remember when you received the scout badge. You learned the treefold or fleur-de-lis shape was to resemble the mirror compass, as it would always point you along the true path towards today. It had three points, which you learned by the three fingers of the scout sign, were for the three points of the scout oath. Remember when you took those first steps up along scouting trail. You began to build yourself physically, mentally, morally by learning the scout oath and scout law. Before you knew it, you were a tenderfoot scout. Scouts. Your scout badge was replaced with a badge of a tenderfoot. It still pointed you in the right direction, but added with the two stars, which represented the truth and knowledge you had gained in scouting. Also was the bald eagle, our national symbol. You learned from the shield on the eagle's breast that the freedom of America is not without cost and that it must be defended. Soon, you reached the first ledge where you were greeted by a large class of second-class scouts. The second class badge showed you the scroll with the motto, "Be prepared." The ends were turned up in a smile. That is what you were doing. As the bottom knot reminded you to do a good turn daily, which is the scout slogan. And yes, you found that some second class scouts have been there for a long time and were content with their achievement. But you continued onward. You studied, and before you realized it, you'd come to a new ledge. One of our first class scouts 12. There you found a tinted green meadow by a crystal clear stream. Bathed by the sun. Here you were tempted to remain. Yes, you could have remained there to live in first class glory, but your ambition stirred you on. You wanted to learn more in scouting, so you continued onward, earning specific skills through merit badges. And yes, we remember your advancement to Star Scout. Star badge. The golden star was to symbolize your new role as a leader. You were called upon to be a guiding light in the darkness for those who were to follow. No longer were you receiving scouting, but now you're expected to teach new skills to others. And yes, now the trail is steeper and less worn. Fewer scouts seem to be heading in your direction. Leadership is challenging and also hard work. You looked down and saw the crowds below you. You looked up and saw a few scouts above you. But you persevered, climbing the steep trail. Soon you earned the badge of a life scout. valued life. Your pure red heart on the golden field show the entire world the path you had chosen. True to the ideas of scouting, you gained the inner confidence that was to prepare you for the rest of your life. And yes, the trail became even tougher, but also more interesting. You thought, now, I am close to the eagle. I will carry on. The original principles, the scout oath, the scout law, now had a fuller meaning. And your understanding of them was greater. Scouts, we have watched your character unfold and watched you become man leader. We have watched your leadership ability expand into a valuable asset. We have watched your mind develop and your wisdom increase. We have watched all those things in you, and as you're the threshold of your goal, we welcome you. You've done your climbing the tree with Scout like that. And now, I would like to introduce the Troops of Action, Troop 250's Eagle Scout Coordinator, to award the Eagle rank.
The awarding of Eagle Scout is an important and serious occasion. It is the culmination of the efforts of the parents and various leaders of these scouts. The Eagle Award is the highest and most coveted rank in scouting, the last major step in the advancement program. Fewer than 4% of all scouts in the United States ever reach the Eagle rank. At this point, we trust that you have perceived and achieved your purpose in building of character, training with leadership, and the practice of service. These applicants have demonstrated their capacity and willingness to exert leadership in the activities that are constructive and worthwhile in this community. The record has been checked into troop leadership, school affairs, and in other fields of work and service. They've demonstrated loyalty and duty to God and country. We believe them qualified to receive the rank of Eagle Scout. It's time I'd like to read the resume of Travis, whose personal scouting and scouting history. Travis joined scouting in first grade, then five, and was there from Tiger to Wigloos two. His last year of scouting, Cub Scouting, he won first place Conwood Derby. He also won second place in Best Design at the Conwood Derby. He earned Super Achiever Award for earning all 20 Weevil pins. He also participated in God and Me and God and Family program. He earned the World Conservation and the Leaf of Trace, and also earned an Arrow of Light, which is the highest rank in Cub Scouts. He moved on to Troop 250, where he was a DIN chief for DIN 6. He's working to earn his bronze Eagle Palm at this time. He earned a scouting segment for National Outdoor Award. And he's enjoyed all the activities of scouting, such as caving, whitewater rafting, and rappelling. His Eagle project was the Meditation and Prayer Garden at Journey Church. In school, he is all honor roll for 3 years in middle school. He was a member of the National Junior Beta Club. He's also a South Carolina Junior Scholar. He has all honor courses in high school with all A's, and he was inducted in the Beta Club in the 10th grade. Travis is interested in an engineering field and medical field and plans to attend college, and from there, get himself a good job. I'd like to read the resume of Spence Dulin's personal and scouting history. Spencer joined as Tiger in 2007. He earned all 20 Wigloos badges and achieved the Super Achiever Award. He also participated in God and Me and God Family programs, received the World Conservation Award, Leave No Trace, well as the Outdoor Activity Award. Participated in the Pinewood Derby and was first place for dim speed 3 times. And earned the Arrow of Light as he crossed over to Boy Scouts in February 2012. As a member of the troop, he's been a patrol leader and assistant senior patrol leader from July 2013 to 2015. He completed the Order of the Arrows ordeal in August 13 and went to the Fall Fellowship in 2013. Completed the SEALS program training. Also participated in the ILST training, all leadership training programs. Earned the National Outdoor Award and has earned the Mile Swim and Polar Bear Swim. In church, he's a member of First Baptist and Fort Mill and is part of the youth leadership team. He served as a volunteer for Victory Sports Outreach, which was a mission trip to St. George, South Carolina. And he's been a camp counselor at sports camps for 2 summers. In school, he's a member. He was in GT classes from 3rd to 8th grade. He was recommended for the people ambassador program to do in the 5th grade. He placed first in the 7th grade school science fair, and he's also a junior scholar. He's now a sophomore at Fort Mill High School in online classes. Participates in the church in the concert chorus and went to London over break in 2016. He's been accepted as a senior national Alpha Beta Club at Fort Mill High School in his sophomore year. He's played sports at Gold Hill Middle School and was captain of the 8th grade team at that time. He is also a member of the Gold Hill Middle School basketball team and is now a junior varsity soccer team member in his freshman year at Fort Mill High School. He plans to attend college and pursue a degree related to film and acting. His Eagle project were improvements to the Gold Hill Middle School nature trail. I'd like to read the resume of Nate Shive's personal scouting history. Nate began scouting in Pack 250 and then 8 in 2007. After advancing through the ranks, he bridged over to Boy Scouts in 2011. As part of Den 9, he was awarded the National Den Award, and there he also earned the Arrow of Light. He bridged to the Boy Scouts and became a member of the Cougar Patrol. Advanced through the ranks now to Eagle Scout. He was asked to join the Order of the Arrow in 2015, where he has also earned both SEALS and NYLT scouting qualifications. Again, SEALS and NYLT are leadership programs in scouting. The NYLT is by invitation. Outstanding outside of scouting, Nate's been active in the Junior Beta Club. And he also is a member of Where Everyone Belongs in middle school. He was active in his church working between scenes and the media ministry and the Faith Cafe. He's earned his deputy black belt in Taekwondo and is working towards his first degree black belt. He's currently a student at Fort Mill High School in pursuit of aerospace engineering degree. He's also active in the Marine Corps Junior ROTC program. Following high school, he's interested in pursuing an engineering degree at the Citadel. He hopes to receive a commission of second lieutenant in the U.S. Army. We challenge these scouts to accept the responsibility as well as the honor of Eagle Scout. These responsibilities are as follows. An Eagle Scout is to live with honor. His honor is sacred. It is the foundation of all character. An Eagle Scout will live so that he reflects credit upon his home, church, school, friends, and self. May the white of your badge remind you to live with honor. an Eagle Scout is loyal. To thine own self be true, and it follows as the night or day. Thou canst not then be false to any man. Neither pain nor profit, pride nor personal loss shall sway his loyalty. The blue of your badge is the emblem of loyalty. An Eagle Scout is courageous. Courage gives all character force and strength. With the trust in God and faith in his fellow man, he faces each day unafraid and seeks his share of the world's work to do. Let the red of your badge remind you of courage. Finally, an Eagle Scout is service-oriented, extending a helping hand to those who toil along the scouting trail that you have completed, just as the others have aided each of you. The daily good turn must take on a new meaning and better the life pattern of service. Protect and defend the weak and helpless, comfort the unfortunate and the oppressed. Uphold the rights of others as well as your own. And remember that leadership is founded upon real service. In recognition of these obligations, I now ask you to please stand and reaffirm the Scout Oath. Scout sign. On my honor.
I will do my best to do my duty, to guard my country, to obey the Scout Law, to help other people at all times, to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight.
Two. Will Alex Surrett please come forward as representative of the National Council of Boy Scouts of America and administer the Eagle Badge?
I have the very distinct pleasure and honor of being able to do the Eagle Pledge. This is by far personally my favorite thing I get to do in my role. So thank you for letting me come and do this. I have the honor to give you the Eagle Pledge on this occasion of your elevation to the highest ranking scout. The Boy Scouts of all nations constitute one of the most wholesome and significant influences in the world's history. You have been counted worthy of this high rank in the Boy Scouts of America. Build America on the sound foundations of clean living, honest work, citizenship, and reverence for God. Then, whatever others do, you will leave behind you a record of which you may be justly proud. Eagle Scouts Travis Pence, Spencer Dulin, and Nate Shive, by repetition of the Eagle Scout promise, before your fellow members, you become an Eagle Scout. Though the words you use will be similar to those by which you joined Scout, today they will mean more than they could have ever meant at any time in the past. When you pledge yourself on your sacred honor, you will be sealing your eternal loyalty to the code of the Eagle Scout. Will all Eagle Scouts present, whether in uniform or not, both from the troop and from the audience, please come forward and join Travis, Spencer, and Nate to form a circle together and reaffirm the code of the Eagle Scout. Attention, Scout sign, and repeat after me. I reaffirm my allegiance.
I reaffirm my allegiance.
To the three promises of the Scout Oath.
To the three promises of the Scout Oath.
I thoughtfully recognize.
I thoughtfully recognize.
And take upon myself.
And take upon myself.
The obligations and responsibilities.
The obligations and responsibilities.
Of the rank of Eagle Scout.
Of the rank of Eagle Scout.
On my honor, I will do my best.
On my honor, I will do my best.
To make my training an example.
made my training an example.
My rank and my influence.
My rank and my influence.
Count strongly for better citizenship.
Count strongly for better citizenship.
In my troop.
In my troop.
And in my church.
And in my church.
And in my community.
And in my community.
And in my contacts with other people.
And in my contacts with other people.
To this, I pledge my word of honor.
To this, I pledge my word of honor.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Will the Eagle candidates now please escort your parents to the front? Fellow Eagle Scouts, we now proclaim to the entire world your accomplishments. The symbol of your success is the Eagle Badge, which will now be presented to your parents, and in turn your parents will pin the badge over your heart. Eagle Scouts Travis Pence, Spencer Dulin, Nate Shive, in recognition of the wisdom and guidance given to you by your father, will you now please present with him with his Eagle lapel pin, which you will proudly wear in your honor. These pins are never easy to put on. And now, also in recognition of the many hours of patient guidance given by her in your efforts, would you now please pin your Eagle's mother's pin on your mother's ribbon? And now, in true Troop 250 tradition, please apply the Eagle Scout mother's kiss. Eagle Scouts, if you'll please take this token of appreciation to your grandparents as you escort your parents back to their seats, and please return to the stage. At this time, the Eagle Scouts would like to now present their pins to their mentors. When the Scouts recognize their mentor, they would like to ask each mentor to come forward to the stage to receive their pin. Travis, sorry.
The first person that I would like to give a mentor pin to is someone that early on my journey to Eagle. This person has been very early years of scouting. Very fun and enjoyable with everything from making jump air racers to making periscopes, into your garage, even just having a good time in your backyard. This person taught me that you could learn things and actually have a good time while doing it. I don't know how I ever made it to past Cup to Cups without it. Unfortunately, Miss Katrina could not be here today. This next person that I'd like to give a mentor print to has always been there since the very beginning. He has always been a familiar face that I can knew I could rely on. Not anything from a camp out to like a water rafting trip. He's always been around since before I joined Scouting, and I just felt like if I needed something, I knew it would be there. Mr. Scott, would you please come forward and speak to my mentor? Now this last person I'd like to give a mentor pin to has been with me the whole way through. They have always had my back and never stopped pushing me to do my best. They taught me that if I never gave up and gave them out, that I could accomplish anything. I don't know how I would have made it without your guidance. Mom, you can do, please come forward and see your mentor pin.
My first mentor pin was also to Miss Katrina Blankenhorn, who couldn't be here. She was my lead delegator from Tiger all the way through Beaver Lowe's, and who taught me the basics of scouting, also with a variety of skills, and set the foundation for my whole scouting career. And she also helped me learn a lot about life and all the 20 Beaver Lowe badges. But unfortunately, she couldn't be here. My second, Mr. Scott Johnson, who was also helped our den as a co-den leader and provided guidance with belt loops and pins. And he had this, always had this joke about encouraging me to get my wings before the fumes hit, as in perfumes and gas fumes. At age 9, I didn't really understand, but I did do that. I served through most of my time in the troop, and so he was several merit badges as well. And he was always available if I needed him for anything, and he provided encouragement to continue on my journey with Eagle. But my most memorable moment is probably when I impersonated him, the Scoutmaster minute, which was like, not a minute, but it was like in 10. Mr. Mercer. My fourth one is Mr. Ripple, who couldn't be here. He's our current Scoutmaster, the Scoutmaster through the end of my journey. He helped me a lot with the various steps of through the Eagle process, as my workbook and my board. Last but not least, I'd like to thank Mr. Dasher, who's provided me with direction and encouragement to complete my Eagle project, and who's made sure that I was prepared prior to my district board and everything that I needed with my Eagle.
My first mentor is someone who has been with me the majority of my scouting career. This person has been an inspiration not to only myself, but to my fellow scouts, and has managed to keep us focused on the end goal of Eagle Scout. This person guided me and my fellow scouts, ensuring that we completed all of our merit badges and our requirements. This person has kept me focused, and without this person, I wouldn't be where I am today. This person embodies the scout law and is a living example of what a scout should be. My number one mentor is Miss Julie Howe. My second mentor pin is my dad, Gary Shive. He is an amazing man. He's encouraged me to become an Eagle Scout and a better person in general. If it weren't for my dad, I would probably be still on the couch pushing out my Eagle Scout project until it's too late. My dad was persistent with forcing me to get my project done. My dad has inspired me on my career path. I wish one day I could be as strong and powerful as my dad is.
Now, Eagle Scouts, as you can see on the plaque we have here against the wall, your names have been placed on the Troop 250's permanent Eagle plaque for all time. This time I'd also like to make note that Travis Pence was the 100th Eagle Scout in our troop. So we now have 100 Eagle Scouts, and Travis was our first 100. We're up to 105 now. Travis was our big number 100. We're extremely proud of your achievement and equally proud of your progress along the scouting trail. Now, as a small token of our pride in you, I now have the honor to present you with this special neckerchief from Troop 250, which is emblematic of all Eagle Scouts everywhere in recognition of your outstanding service to this troop and to becoming an Eagle Scout. Eagle Scouts, please stand. Please wear this neckerchief with pride in our program and with pride in your personal achievement. Thank you very much. And at this point, I'd like to read some congratulatory letters that the Boys have received. Travis Pence, congratulations on earning the rank of Eagle Scout. We hope you take tremendous pride in the hard work and commitment to service that brought you to this moment. This achievement speaks to your role as a young leader in your community. We encourage you to continue taking on new projects, setting a positive example, and striving to make a difference. Young people like you give us great hope for the future, and we wish you all the best. Signed, Barack and Michelle Obama. Dear Eagle Scout Spencer Dulin, congratulations on achieving the rank of Eagle Scout, the highest honor of a Boy Scout can receive. I am very aware of how much time and effort goes into reaching this rank, and I want to personally congratulate you and your family and commend you for your efforts. Your project of renovating and improving the nature trail, benches, and observation deck near the Gold Hill Schools was a great way to give back to the community and schools, and you're to be commended for this project. I am sure that many will benefit from your leadership and efforts through this project for years to come. As your pastor, it has been a privilege to watch you grow and develop as a young man and as a follower of Jesus Christ. I want to encourage you to continue to grow and develop as Jesus did, in wisdom and in stature and in favor with God and man, Luke 52. I am confident that God will continue to do mighty work in and through you for the years to come. As you remember the many people who have invested your life, in your life, especially your family, I want to challenge you with these words from the book of Hebrews. Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witness, let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely. And let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God. Hebrews 12:1-2. I am sure that this achievement of Eagle Scout is just the beginning of things that God will continue to do through your life as you talk with him. I am celebrating with you and your family and looking forward to all that lies ahead for you in the years to come. In Christ, Pastor Jeff Beckman. Dear Eagle Scout Shive, congratulations on achieving the rank of Eagle Scout. You and your family should be very proud of a distinction that speaks so highly of your dedication and integrity and willingness to serve others. I have a special appreciation for Eagle Scouts because I see who they develop into while in college. When reviewing the background of our Corps of Cadet Leadership, I find more often than not they are Eagle Scouts. If you were to come to the Citadel to further your education, the same pursuit of excellence and drive to come overcome challenges would serve you well. The Citadel community joins me in sending you best wishes for your future success. I know that you will continue to build on this foundation of leadership and service. Well done. Sincerely, John Dub Rosa, Lieutenant General, USAF, retired. At this time, I'd like to introduce our state representative, Mr. Ralph Norman, to please come and make a special presentation.
Thank you, Luther. To the Scout leaders, to the Scout, to the Eagle Scouts, parents, family and friends, mentors, it is a privilege to take part in this ceremony. You know, as I was watching candles being lit, the families pinning the pins on their Eagle Scout. It shows you how great this country is, the fact that we can get together in freedom and celebrate God and the country. You know, and I've never read, I'm sure there's been some, but I've never heard of a scout that ever gets in trouble. They're your leaders. They're your professionals. And it's just an honor to take place today. I'd like to read, I've got a House resolution for Nate. Spence and Travis would be happy to get one for y'all. Send me your information. But it's from the Speaker of the House, and let me read it. Congratulating this outstanding young man upon being the recipient of the prestigious Eagle Scout Award. Nate is commended for his hard work and dedication in completing his Eagle Scout project. He has been active in scouting for 7 years and has attended National Youth Leadership Training. Scouts are excited about leadership skills and is a member of the Order of the Arrow. He has been an inspiration to his peers and has brought pride to his parents, to his community, and to the state of South Carolina. Nate John Robert Shive proudly wears his scouting uniform and the emblem, which represents the more than 200 million scouts who have worn this emblem since the inception of scouting. We honor him as he receives the highest award given in scouting, presented to him during the Court of Honor ceremony that is held on the 18th day. I would also extend an invitation for the families and friends to come to the State House. If you haven't been there, be my guest. We'd love to have you there. We start back in January. And again, thank you for allowing me a small part in this presentation today. It's a great honor. Thank you.
Such a great experience that I'll never forget.
was like probably one of the first ones who saw leadership skills in me that I really didn't know that I had at that point. So she nominated me for People to People Leadership Program, which was founded by Dwight D. Eisenhower, in which I had the opportunity to participate in the summer after sixth grade, where we went to Washington, D.C. And through this program, I met students from all over the U.S. and was able to improve my leadership skills, which has helped me in my leadership roles in Scouts now. Second, I'd like to thank Ms. Nancy Swicegood. She's been my connect leader ever since I can remember, since about fourth grade maybe, in for Sunday school. She's helped me grow in my faith immensely, and she always encourages me to witness to others, and she's always there if I need her. I'd like to thank Pastor John Caruso, and he's been my youth pastor since the sixth grade, and he pours into the lives of students and gets real with us, as he likes to call it. And he challenges us to grow in our faith and our boldness to share Christ with others. And I'd also like to thank you for doing that opening and the closing prayer. I'd like to thank my grandparents. They followed our family from Virginia to South Carolina when we moved, just so they could be near us and involved with the activities that my sister and I were in. And they've attended various scouting events from when I was a Tiger to today. And they've supported me each year through little things like purchases of popcorn they would buy that I didn't win money. And I'd just like to thank them. I'd like to thank my sister. She was always there for me when I needed her, and she just encouraged me through every aspect of life. And she was a major person who taught me patience. And lastly, I'd like to thank my parents. They've literally walked, hiked, and biked this journey with me from my first Debbie to today. My mom hiked 60 miles with me just so I could earn the hiking merit badge, which one of the hikes was 20 in one day. And my dad biked 150 miles with me just so I could earn the cycling merit, which was 50 miles in a day, one of them was. And then the support, encouragement, and belief that they supported me, that I would become the Eagle one day was also known through verbal reminders, like little post-it notes during the summer when my mom would leave me, even though I didn't want to do it. And little did I know that those just helped me complete several merit badges, like the requirement at the time. And the last 2 years were pretty challenging just because with my other activities, and my mom often used the words cattle prod, which never had one used on me, but I have a feeling that it'd be more persuasive than the post-it notes when I left. And I'd just like to thank you, because without you guys, I wouldn't be here.
I would like to thank Grace Presbyterian for catering this organization, which has provided the venue that has allowed me to experience all aspects of Boy Scouts. I would like to thank all leaders of the troop, past and present, for working on making all the gears move smoothly through my career. I would like to personally thank Mr. Mahoney for helping me through my ranks of Boy Scouts. I would like to thank Mr. John Scales for being there in my early years. He set a great example that no man can do as much as Mr. John did. I would like to thank Mr. Ralph Norman for taking the time out of his busy schedule to attend the Eagle Scout Court of Honor and the steps he took to recognize this achievement in the great state of South Carolina State Assembly. I'd like to thank Pastor Brian, my home church pastor and congregation at Faith Assembly, for believing in my abilities and sponsoring my Eagle Scout project. I would like to thank my scouting family. You know who you are. Thank you for making my scouting experience enjoyable and all the memories we have had shared together over the years. I'd like to thank my parents for supporting me on my Eagle Scout, at the Eagle Scout.
Pastor in front of the name to get behind a pulpit in the church.
attention to things that probably most of you, not me, but most of you and some of you maybe aren't aware of what just happened here. Because first of all, I'll say, gosh, guys, awesome for the achievements you've done. But I just want you to know, I know you know this, it would not have been done without these people, and I'm assuming there are other ones since they got up here, the ones on the front row here, your parents, wouldn't have been done without that. And that all of your life you're going to be going to them for guidance. All of your life you're going to be going to them for information, for things you don't know, for things you need to know. I mean, and these other men and women who were called up here that you gave hugs to, that you have just fed into your life. And parents are awesome. Gosh, I mean, I've been a parent and had to prod and push and cajole my daughters out of bed to do things that they didn't want to do, but you knew was the thing they needed to do. It's probably most of the reason why they're sitting here is because of you anyway. So you need more than just a hug or a little badge there or whatever. Man, that's awesome. It is awesome. But a couple of things that I noticed that are very unusual about what happened this afternoon that you don't see outside these doors often. Words that were said. Leadership. Love of God and love of country. Honor. Service. Character. And interesting enough, those are all biblical terms. They all come from God's Word. And so I don't know where your relationship with the Lord is today. You may not have come here. You may have come to honor these young men, which they need to be honored, and these parents who need to be honored. But the number one person that needs to be honored is the Lord with your life and with your service. So let's go ahead and pray. Father, we do thank you for this day. And Lord, you are the Lord of all creation. You're the Lord of all of us, whether we acknowledge you or not. Father, you're the one that we're to come to when we're in need. Father, words can't express what I felt in my heart about these three young men up here, Father, that the things that they've accomplished and things that they've done and the parents that have pushed and prodded them to help them accomplish this even at such a young age. But most of all, Lord, I pray that they would continue to walk in those ways, those principles and precepts that were set before us a long, long time ago in your word. And Lord, that they would continue to walk in those and be godly young men in Jesus' name.
And as a representative of the Palmetto Council of Boy Scouts America and the National Council of the Boy Scouts, I now declare this Court of Honor closed. I will now ask the Senior Patrol Leader to come forward and retire the colors, and after the Eagle parents are escorted out, you are all dismissed. Thank you very much.
Would everyone please stand for the retirement of the colors and remain standing until the Eagle parents are escorted out in your expenses. Color guard, retrieve the colors. Color guard, forward march. Salute. Ready two. Will the Eagle Scouts now escort the parents?